Sir.
Yes. Okay, we'll start.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll start. Good evening, everybody. I welcome you all to this August forum. And this very important webinar today. I welcome Professor Afroz Alam, who is head department of political science, Maulana Azad National University, Hyderabad. The topic for this evening, you all know, understanding West Bengal Assembly election result 2021, why Mamata Banerjee won and why Narendra Modi lost. I would also like to thank Professor Sanjeev Reddy for introducing Professor Afroz Alam to this forum today. TJ, Telangana Janavedika, as you all know, is relentlessly throwing light on contemporary issues by conducting weekly seminars, and this is the 379th meeting. As you all know now, we are living in torrid times with the pandemic raging a war on humanity worldwide. We had a countrywide lockdown. And the migrant labor workers from rural India who came to metro cities for livelihood were closed and had to walk thousands of kilometers without any transportation facilities. And as the curve slowed down and the unlocked down, the government, with their laxity, I don't know what to say, has conducted elections in 4 states and 1 union territory. And as you all know, West Bengal had gone to eight phase elections in eight phase manner. And the main target here again was Mamata Banerjee, who was the chief minister and who was trying, incumbent chief minister, and was trying to get a third term. And in this election, it was particularly in Bengal, it was an election between nationalism and regionalism. And one more aspect is local, non-local. Local, non-local election, and as you all know, the Prime Minister and the Home Minister went around the Bengal, total West Bengal, for about 6 months, almost 6 months before the election. They were targeting Mamata Banerjee. They were poaching. They were poaching leadership from other parties, particularly Congress Party, CPM Party, and particularly TMC also. So this election is actually will be a curtain riser to the 2024 elections for the coming parliament elections in India. So therefore, this election and therefore, we have to take care. We have to have an analytical revive of these election results. And I have remind you one aspect here. After 1980, Indira Gandhi's comeback, H.N. Bhavguna, who was a tall leader then from Uttar Pradesh, he had some issues with Indira Gandhi, and he had resigned the parliament, and he has to contest the election. He has to contest the election from Gadwal in Uttar Pradesh. Now it is in Uttarakhand. And mind you, friends, Indira Gandhi, out of the seven assembly segments in the parliamentary constituency, she had nominated seven chief ministers as in charges for each assembly constituency. And a battery of central ministers campaigned in the election. But however, Bhavguna has won the election with somewhere around 3 lakh votes. So that is what happened in Bengal too. The more concentration by the central government on targeting Mamata Banerjee and booing her as Didi or Didi has resulted in Bengal giving a landslide victory to Mamata Banerjee. This is what has happened in India. However, we have to discuss in detail, and I believe and I assure you that Professor Afroz Alam, with his long standing as a political scientist, he will be explaining us in detail. Now I hand over the mic to Professor Akthota Srinivasulu to conduct the meeting as a moderator and hand over the mic to Professor Alam. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Sir, vinavartunda meeku? Sir, vinavartunda? Sir, vinavartunda?
Vinavartunda.
Sir, okay. Thank you, sir. Telangana Janavedika Zoom online meeting ku vichesinatvanti ప్రొఫెసర్ అఫ్రోజ్ ఆలం గారికి మరియు కన్వీనర్ రాము గారికి ఇతర సభ్యులు మిత్రులందరికీ నా సాయంకాల నమస్కారాలు తెలియజేస్తూ ఇంతకుముందే రాము సారు అనేక విషయాలు ఇప్పుడే మాట్లాడారు వారు ప్రొఫెసర్ అఫ్రోజ్ ఆలం గురించి. ప్రధానంగా ఇవాళ 2021 సంవత్సరం అంటే వారం రోజుల క్రితం ఎలక్షన్ల రిపోర్ట్ వచ్చినటువంటి బెంగాల్ శాసనసభ ఎన్నికల ఫలితాలు, మమతా బెనర్జీ గెలుపు, నరేంద్ర మోడీ గారి ఓటమి అనేటువంటి టాపిక్ మీద మనం మాట్లాడుతున్నాం. నిజంగా ఇది చాలా కాంట్రవర్సీకి సంబంధించినటువంటి ఇష్యూగానే నేను భావిస్తూ, ముఖ్యంగా ఒకవైపు భారతదేశంలో జాతీయ పార్టీలు ఉండాలని చెప్పేసి మనం ఒకవైపు కోరుకుంటూ ప్రధానంగా ఈ దేశంలో ఉండేటువంటి గతంలో ఉండేటువంటి జాతీయ పార్టీలు అయినటువంటి కాంగ్రెస్ పార్టీ కానీ లేదా బీజేపీ పార్టీ కానీ సిపిఐ కానీ సిపిఎం కానీ ఇతర ఏవైతే జాతీయ పార్టీలు ఉన్నాయో ఆ పార్టీలన్నీ కనుమరుగైపోయి కేవలం ఇవాళ ఒకే ఒక భారతీయ జనతా పార్టీ మనకు కనబడుతుంది. ఆ తర్వాత మరి ఒక పార్టీ అయినటువంటి కాంగ్రెస్ పార్టీ కూడా కేవలం ప్రాంతీయ పార్టీ వైపుగా ప్రయాణం చేస్తున్నట్టుగా మనకు కనబడుతుంది. అయితే కాంగ్రెస్ పార్టీని మనము ఇవాళ జాతీయ పార్టీగా గుర్తించాలా స్థానిక పార్టీగా గుర్తించాలనేటువంటిది ఒక ప్రధాన అంశం కాగా, మమతా బెనర్జీ గారు గతంలో ఇదే ఎన్డీఏ ప్రభుత్వంలో ఆమె సెంట్రల్ మినిస్టర్ గా పనిచేయడం అనేటువంటిది ఒకటి ప్రధానంగా మనం గుర్తుపెట్టుకోవాలి. అయితే మొన్న జరిగినటువంటి ఈ ఎన్నికలన్నీ కూడా ఒకవైపు జాతీయ భావం అని ఒకరు అంటూ ఉంటే ఇంకొకరు మతాన్ని దృష్టిలో పెట్టుకొని మత ఆధారంగా జరిగిన ఈ ఎన్నికలు అనేటువంటిది ప్రధానమైనటువంటి అంశం. నిజానికి ఇది నేషనాలిటీయా లేదా మతానికి సంబంధించినటువంటి ఎలక్షన్లా అనేటువంటిది ప్రజల ముందు ఉన్నటువంటి ప్రధానమైనటువంటి ప్రశ్న. అంటే మతాన్ని దృష్టిలో పెట్టుకుంటే ఓ రకమైనటువంటి రిజల్ట్, జాతీయత దృష్టిలో పెట్టుకుంటే ఓ రకమైనటువంటి రిజల్ట్ వచ్చినట్టుగానే మనకు కనబడుతుంది. అందుకే ఇవాళ సరే మనము మోడీ గారి ఓటమి అని ఎట్లా చెప్పుకుంటాము అంటే చెప్పుకునేటువంటి అవకాశం కూడా లేదని అనుకుంటున్నాం. గతంలో ఆయనకు 3 సీట్లకు ఉన్నటువంటి బీజేపీ పార్టీకి 3 సీట్లు ఉన్నటువంటి బెంగాల్లో, పశ్చిమ బెంగాల్లో ఇవాళ సుమారుగా 90 స్థానాలు గెలవడం అనేటువంటిది గొప్ప విజయంగానే మనం చెప్పుకోవాలి. అదేవిధంగా ఇంకొక 90 సీట్లు 1000 లోపల ఉండేటువంటి ఆ ఓట్ల తేడాతోని ఇంకొక 90 సీట్లు ఓడిపోయాడు. అంటే 90, 90, 180, 1000 ఓట్లు కనుక ఆయనకు వచ్చినట్లే అంటే ఇంకో 90 సీట్లు వచ్చాయి. అంటే ఓవరాల్ గా 180 సీట్లు వచ్చేటువంటి అవకాశం ఉండేటువంటి బెంగాల్ లోపల మనము మోడీ గారిని ఓటమి అనాలా అనేటువంటిది ఇక్కడ కొద్దిగా మరి ప్రొఫెసర్ ఆలం గారి యొక్క విశ్లేషణను చూడవలసినటువంటి అవసరం ఎంత ఉంది. సరే మమతా బెనర్జీ గారు కూడా ఎన్డీఏలో గతంలో ఎన్డీఏ ప్రభుత్వంలో పనిచేశారు, సెంట్రల్ మినిస్టర్ గా పనిచేశారు. సరే ఇవాళ వారు గెలవడం అనేటువంటిది సంతోషకరమైనటువంటి విషయమే. ఇవి వారి గెలుపును మనం ఆహ్వానిస్తూనే ప్రధానంగా జాతీయ పార్టీల యొక్క గుర్తింపు అనేటువంటిది ఇంకా మనం గుర్తించవలసినటువంటి అవసరం ఉంది. ప్రపంచ దేశాల్లో కేవలం జాతీయ పార్టీలనే గుర్తిస్తారు కానీ స్థానిక పార్టీల యొక్క గుర్తింపు అనేటువంటిది ఉండదు. మన కేసీఆర్ లాంటి వారు కానీ, మమతా బెనర్జీ వంటి వారు కానీ, మన యొక్క నిన్న గెలిచినటువంటి ఆ పక్కనే ఉండేటువంటి తమిళనాడు రాష్ట్రంలో ఉండేటువంటి ఎవరినైనా కూడా ఈ యొక్క ప్రాంతీయ పార్టీలను గుర్తించుకోవడం కష్టం కానీ జాతీయ స్థాయి లోపల ఉండేటువంటి ప్రధాన పార్టీలే మనం ఇవాళ గుర్తించుకోవాల్సినటువంటి అవసరము. ఏది ఏమైనప్పటికీ ఈ యొక్క పశ్చిమ బెంగాల్ శాసనసభ ఎన్నికల ఫలితాలు, మమతా బెనర్జీ గారి గెలుపు, నరేంద్ర మోడీ గారి ఓటమి పైన ఒక విశ్లేషణ అనేటువంటి అంశం మీద ప్రొఫెసర్ అఫ్రోజ్ ఆలం గారు, వారు డిపార్ట్మెంటల్ సైన్స్ మౌలానా ఆజాద్ నేషనల్ ఓపెన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ లో హైదరాబాద్ లో వారు పనిచేస్తున్నారు, వారు సీనియర్ ప్రొఫెసర్ గా పనిచేస్తున్నారు, హెడ్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ గా పొలిటికల్ సైన్స్ లో పనిచేస్తున్నారు, వాటిని మాట్లాడంగా ఆహ్వానిస్తున్నారు. సార్ ప్రొఫెసర్ ఆలం గారు ప్లీజ్ సార్.
థ్యాంక్ యూ అండ్ వెరీ గుడ్ ఈవెనింగ్ to be a part of this program. My sincere thank you Reddy sir and Srinivaslu sir who just moderated the program. Am I audible?
You are sir, you are.
All right, so there were elections in India for almost 5 assemblies, but everybody was talking about what is going to happen in West Bengal. So because in 4 other assembly elections results were almost clear who is going to win and who is going to lose, but West Bengal was a very special state and for which most of us were concerned what is going to happen. Let me first put things on record as Ramu Saab started with. We as analysis were not in favor of holding elections when there is a pandemic. Elections could have been postponed because human life is more important than getting a politician elected for an assembly. So that those things were on record, we told earlier as well, even now. Election Commission should have considered many things before holding the election, but somehow the commission decided to go ahead with 5 assembly elections. We also expressed when Bihar election was happening that you should have delayed the elections. But no, what is in hurry and what is more important in democracy, whether demos is important or crazy, I am not able to understand. But anyways, West Bengal happened. Let us have certain preliminary picture. What was there in West Bengal? It's a most populous state, having 9 crore population, with a gender segregation of 51% male and 49% female voters. Rural urban divide is around 68% of West Bengal is lying in rural areas, and while remaining 32% is in urban setup. Similarly, that the literacy rate is 76%, and it's quite a happening place. But if we look at the electoral demography, it contains around 7 crore voters and 51% male and 49% female. Similarly, there were 18 to 19 age categories, young voters who recently enrolled, and they were around 3%. It was a state which is known for greater political happening. If you will start from the early days to now, you will find that a lot of political excitements take place in this state politics. Let us have a picture in West Bengal. There were a time when Congress was a dominant party. Then that dominant party was replaced by Communist Party, Marxist in 77. Then it was replaced by another dominant party, on the Trinamool Congress, leaded by Mamata Banerjee. And then there was an attempt made by Bharatiya Janata Party in 2021 to topple Mamata government, imagining that the similar situation may happen as it happened in 1977, the way it happened in 2011, it may repeat in 2021 as well. So, but it did not happen. Mamata Banerjee sustained the onslaught and became the chief minister again. Again, if you will look at the West Bengal elections, the West Bengal elections have always been very, very organic, and its regional flavors were quite felt across India. It was very distinctive. It used to be very regional. It used to be very ideological as well. But there has never been a time when national grand narratives used to dominate in the state politics. But BJP tried to infuse its own ideological base while for the privileged section of the society, or the Hindu society, or the higher caste people. But it has taken a very reverse social engineering style in West Bengal. It took the roots of appeasing tribals and Dalit population first, convincing them that, see, you are being neglected by the politics of left and Mamata Banerjee. If BJP will come to power, you will be saved from the cut money, from the everyday exploitation of the syndicates and party cadres. And BJP is the only savior. So those were the phenomena. So first time BJP tried to infuse a national Hindutva narrative in the state politics, which was known for its regional flavors. there were lots of challenges before Mamata Banerjee, and what we calculated as the fact that I, as a person who thought, because we used to study elections for the last many decades. So I began my election studies with CSDS when Yogendra Yadav was looking after the Lok Niti program in 1999. So we used to do surveys in Uttar Pradesh. Then when I moved to Hyderabad, again, I did a lot of studies, surveys. Our projections, in fact, my projections were the only projections which were spot on for Bihar elections. We did 90% exact result for Delhi elections, places. So we thought of that the West Bengal election is going to happen. Why not to conduct our own study? So we invested around 4 to 5 months in the state and did a survey of almost 294 assembly constituencies. We picked up three polling stations from each assembly, 600 respondents we interviewed. So over the period of 4 months in West Bengal, our study was concluded till 14th of March 2021. So it was basically a pre-poll study, but we were a great success, spot on in gauging the mood, direction and outcomes of the West Bengal elections. So before I will come to my study, let me have certain pictures. So what were the pictures before us when we started our study? That for the last 45 years, since the start of political party, are the winning combination in West Bengal attained less than 44% of votes. So if for the last trend was that if you are going to be a winning political party, you will be attaining 44% vote minimum. And there was another trend that winning combination in West Bengal would not attain less than 200 seats. So the two things were clear, that if you are going to win the West Bengal Assembly election, you must secure more than 44% votes. Second is more than 200 votes. So the West Bengal voters were quite decisive. Only that is the exception to this rule after that is 77 was 2001 assembly elections when the winning combination secured 196 seats. So left front attained 196 seats, and the seats and the percentage of vote was also the 45%. So idea is we thought of that if this trend is going to be broken or discontinued in 2021 elections. There was another pattern that that is opposition party have attained more than 80 seats, in fact. So the highest winning opposition party gaining votes was 86 seats when Mamata Banerjee and the Indian National Congress joined hands together in 2001. So the 2001 was the only election. So we thought whether that 2021 election was going to be a repeat of 2021 assembly election. So we calculated that because we were looking at the whole picture that Mamata Banerjee was claiming that we are going to emerge as a victorious and BJP will be confined to the 70 seats. While Amit Shah was saying that we are going to have 200 seats, and throughout the period of time, he was proclaiming and keeping the tempo of his party's workers high that we are going to win 200. Actually, what happened that the Mamata's projection got actually realized exactly spot on when she said that we will be winning 210 seats and BJP will be reduced to 70. And this is what actually happened. So one thing was sure that if two propositions we came out with the elections, that in 2000, if we look at the BJP's rise in West Bengal, it's not an overnight rise. They have invested in the state for long, and West Bengal was a right state where the Muslim population is 27% and the Hindu population is around 70%. And that was the state where they failed to polarize, whether that state was their priority or not. So this combo, Amit Shah and the Narendra Modi, thought of experimenting with a state, and they started focusing a state more and more after 2014 elections. Because what happened in 2011 elections, Mamata Banerjee secured 184 seats and 39% votes, and left got almost decimated in that attempt only. Then there was a 2014 election. In 2011 election, BJP secured only around not more than 4% vote. In 2014 elections, Narendra Modi was an aura, but that aura did not sustain in West Bengal, and the party received only 17% vote. But it's a big jump from comparing the 2011 elections. So BJP got hopeful that if they will try hard a charismatic acceptance amongst the lower section of the system, so they implementing it. And I did a piece and did a study in 2016 election. In 2016, JP invested in Jangal Mahal areas where the tribal population is very heavy. Then focused upon set of cars like Mahatos and others, promising them that if the party will come to power, they will be given OBC. Similarly, they promised to one category, that Matua was one population, and where who are Matuas and Rajbangshis and Namasudras, they are the Dalits and the tribal population, mostly bordering who have come from the West Bengal, and they were being promised that once the BJP will, they will be auto citizenship of the Hindu population. So that was of greater appeal amongst them, and that actually helped the BJP to gain certain percentage of votes amongst them, whether it is a northern west northern Bengal, where that is Alipur Dwara is a state, where Jalpaiguri is there, where the Bankura, Purulia, Midnipur, some areas where the tribal populations were quite higher in number. So they experimented in 2016 as well. In the Amit Shah invested hugely from that time onwards, created its own leadership. And left leadership, there were two kinds of left cadres there. The one was that there were cadres who are so ideologically committed that despite party performing poor, they did not leave the party. There were another set of left cadres and workers who were power oriented, who are actually dealing with they were local muscular people, though they were muscle powers in the area, and they had to survive, and they have to survive engaged with each other. So this shifted entirely to BJP, who at least helped them to face the wrath of TMC cadres. So they will have certain say in the power making. Though they shifted, so BJP realized that no, they can say, but that goal of BJP could not realize in 2016 election, because again BJP got reduced to 10% seat and they lost the election. But again in 2019 election, what happened? It was a miracle. For the first time, the huge chunk of the Congress leadership, left leadership, got BJP. Huge. They have resources, they have instituted blackmailing agencies at their hand and disposal. And quite BJP was not interested in anything except people, that either you are with me or not with me approach. So they went on, and Pulwama was the most important element which worked finally in favor of BJP in West Bengal as well, and Narendra Modi attained a huge support. So a political party which secured only 10% votes in the last election 2016 got to 40%. 40% vote is a big, big size in 2019. Similarly, the Mamata Banerjee which has secured 45% votes in 2016 elections, got reduced to 2% vote and secured only 43% vote. So there was a loss of Mamata Banerjee for 2% vote, and for the gain of BJP, there was a 30% votes gain. So BJP become overconfident that if they can gain more than 30% vote, they can also come to power. So if they have made 2019 as a yardstick, that if they will stick to the 2019 game plan, they can come to the power so easily in West Bengal. And they were right in their calculation that if 40% vote is to be taken into account, parliamentary council out of 40 gone, it's a big thing. And similarly, not only 2019, in 2018 there were local elections as well, where when BJP performed well in panchayat elections, Zila Parishad election, and municipal board elections. So BJP become overconfident that winning West Bengal is quite an easy task and they can easily topple West Bengal government, and particularly Mamata Banerjee. So most people seen, and when we calculated that BJP, why that if 2019 is to be in yardstick, then BJP has to get 126 at least in 2021 elections. And the Trinamool Congress should get at least 164 seats. Even then, that is, the TMC was about to win the 2021 election, keeping in view of the 2019 elections. But not is because if BJP has to win the elections, the BJP has to improve minimum 2-3% vote share from its performance of the 2019 election. Means BJP has to secure minimum 2% elections across more than 150 votes. Similarly, if the Mamata was to win the election, she has to increase its 2% vote share. So what actually happened that Mamata Banerjee increased its around, in fact, 5% vote and secured 48%. Phenomenally, this for the first time, Mamata Banerjee has cut the vote of the left and Congress to its size. Mamata Banerjee has mobilized anything which we how it happened. But on the she was at, it was receiving it lost around 0.5% votes from 2019 and then to 77-1 election. So my projection was that in March only the pinned election 16th with my study. If everything happens, in my old calculations, the BJP will be 100 seats. It will not be crossing more than 100 threshold. And 8% vote share will be there for BJP. And around 42-43% vote will be there for TMC. In my calculation, that the left and Congress should have gained at least. They got and the remaining vote went to the advantage of the BJP and TMC. So in that, what was whole my...
Sir, your bandwidth is very low. Sorry.
We did. We had so many questions at our hand.
Professor, your bandwidth is very low. We are losing you.
Okay. Oh, I had some issues with network. Now, is it audible? Again, some issues. I changed the direction. Hello? Am I audible now? No. Am I audible? Ramuji, am I audible? Hello.
Sir, you are audible. Yeah, you are audible, sir. Hello.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, can I proceed?
Yeah, please.
In 2000, okay, thank you. Some internet issues, and today that is, I'm helpless for that. So it was clear that the priority was the
Sir, please unmute yourself, sir.
Okay. Lots of problem here. All right. So, I was scared of a clear choice as a leader of West Bengal, as a CM, but all the power, 65 people were willing for Narendra Modi, that the this 2021 is a sure and sort gain for Mamata Banerjee. It was not an easy game, and the quite worked very hard. But 2021 victory is relevant in multiple sense, and. And in fact, for me, very because I did this, I still believe in the value of classical democracy, and classical democracy, which talks about that the ruling party and opposition both should. So there must be a government, and who is to be questioned, and the government who is given. This election, 2021 election result, has given a roadmap, and that roadmap was that. Is all about how an election goes, how a campaign is to be organized, how people are to be mobilized, and when there is an entire deep polarization, when populism is at peak, when there is a media hype, Delhi media is saying that BJP is going to win the elections and nobody else. And when you are, which has created resources and they have more than any other political parties, and you are facing a political party which got all institutional support, including Election Commission of India, maybe, and the forces, the election, the eight phases election was. To the advantage of the BJP, may have reduced to almost 60 seats if we wouldn't have. With the fact that it has demolished multiple myths. The first myth is that the Amit Shah, the Home Minister, is a political pundit than many others. Similarly, it has also demonstrated the election machine is full and cannot be. And third, it also demolished the myth that the charisma of Mr. Narendra Modi cannot be reduced and cannot be challenged. So the 2020, all the ministers of West Bengal, the ministers, what is happening? So most of the ministers have lost their God. Something has happened scenario. Then the three reasons why it
Yeah, professor.
So it this victory is historic in multiple senses, because in West Bengal election in the last 45 years, a political party is securing more than 213 seats. In fact, it is 218 seats, because two assembly elections is yet to happen, and where BJP is still strong, and there are two BJP MPs have won the elections. They may be losing, relinquishing that assembly seats and keeping the MP seat. So it's quite a special in the sense that a single political party is winning this much of elections. Only in 1972, when Congress has secured 216 seats with 49% votes. So the 1972 is still a record, but that record may have been beaten had there been the election of all these states. Similarly, that the no political parties have retained most of its seats. In fact, 160 seats it has retained out of 209 seats it has won in 2016 elections. Retainment of the seat is also an equally an advantageous. And similarly, that no political parties in the last 45 years have gained 48% of votes. So this is quite a gain for BJP. Similarly, that no single political party has consistently improved its vote share in West Bengal elections. And it can be rectified when the TMC is getting 27% vote in 2006, then increasing to 39% votes in 2011. And again, it went to 45% vote in 2016 and 48% votes in 2021. So the graph of TMC is consistently increasing so far as the vote share is concerned. Similarly, the mega change in West Bengal election with this 2021 election is that for the first time, the West Bengal is getting a bi-party system, two-party system. Earlier that the West Bengal has experienced either single dominant party system or multi-party dominant system. 2021 election is establishing the fact that there will be a two-party system in West Bengal. And in fact, in 2021 election, only three political parties are represented in the assembly. Unlike the 2016 elections, when eight political parties were there in the election. Similarly, this is an election that the two of the dominant national political parties got zero seats, and their vote shares drastically reduced from together that the in 2016 INC and the left of the Congress, Indian National Congress and left together has secured 39%. But in 2021, these two dominant political parties reduced to merely 8% votes, where left secured 5%, the Congress secured only 3% votes. This is a very bigger loss. Similarly, there is another trend setting and in 2021 election is the fact that no political party in the last 45 years secured, no opposition political party has secured more than that, the 77 seats. So BJP has also set a record. It has won, broken the record of an opposition political force. It has emerged a dominant political opposition party in West Bengal. So this is the whole situation. Is the, that this is historic also the has resisted the fact that the only distinct regional narratives. So this is to be taken into account, and similarly it is also historic because for the first time in India a female chief minister is elected three times consecutively. So and as well as unlike 2019 elections, this time in 2021 146 candidates wasting the elections from BJP tickets where party switches. So they have that Dal Badlu candidate, that they were the candidates where once upon a time were part of the left, Congress and TMC. Only six of them won the election. So the electorates have completely demolished them. Now the point is to be analyzed that why and how TMC has won the election. So let me tell you, my friends, that for the first time an incumbent party has reduced its anti-incumbency, which was quite deep and realized in 2019 election, into pro-incumbency in the less than 2 years' time. So an incumbent party converting anti-incumbency into pro-incumbency is to account why and how it happened. First task that Mamata Banerjee did was to hire a professional agency which has correctly analyzed and assessed that what are the shortcomings over the 2 years and why did it perform poorly in the Lok Sabha election 2019. And they were also on taking huge risk in kicking some of the party workers who were involved in anti-party activities out. They were coming out from the direct constituency report. Similarly, TMC has identified with a greater clarity and much confidence that what are the drawbacks of the the TMC, and they have identified that there was in Amphan management that there was a cyclone where the benefits did not reach out to the people clearly, and the people were so angry. But reduction of people against the Mamata Banerjee was quite a challenge. They worked on it. Similarly, they have realized that there is anti-incumbency amongst the workers class and the poorest class of the section. So they reached out to them. They came out with lots of schemes and they have actually delivered those schemes. 100 plus schemes were being launched. And the most important was the Dware Sarkar. Dware Sarkar reaching out to the doors of the election. High pitch on Hindutva appeal. They are focusing on that. TMC has always done minority appeasement, Durga Puja's immersion of the Durga Murtis and the similarly the favor by TMC to the Imams and Muazzin was being highlighted. And how Muharram are being brought into the picture. Similarly, that they have also realized there are a non-Bengali population in West Bengal who are angry with the party and they may not be supporting it. And the most important factor was the caste dynamics, which the BJP was pitching before the TMC. And they actually worked on them. So entire whole scheme, the Minority Morcha and Dalit Morcha and the OBC Morcha, Dalit Morcha, which were once formed in 2011 and got activated. Then there was a youth wing. The youth were being quite mobilized, the people. And that is why the increase has been seen that almost 14% MLAs elected by the TMC are from 25 age to 35 age category group. So the youth were being roped in. The students were being roped in, then the women were the most, because women consistently voted Mamata Banerjee for them specifically. If we take the women voters, So 100 women specific schemes were being being rolled in, like Swas Sati, Rupa Shri, Kanya Shri, lots of schemes, and the free laptops and the cycles were being distributed. That actually worked to the advantage of the Mamata Banerjee. Lots of were being given in the representation in the organizational setup to participate in campaigns, in meetings, in going around. And most celebrity women, the Telangana film industry heroines and actresses, and that is why the representation of the women again remain the same. 14% female MLAs are there, quite in higher comparing other states as well. So they were given more and more tickets. This comes so that this was highly technologically advanced. There were psychographic analysis, there were metadata used in the electoral mapping of the constituency, and they have created around a database of 5 crore voters using the shopping browsing data, and then the social media data. They were quite active in giving ads to the Facebook, to Twitter, Instagram, quite on right time when the elections were due. So it was highly technically advanced state, and for the first time TMC was giving an equal challenge to BJP. So similarly, that the what flavor of the Mamata Banerjee was the Bengali Asmita campaign. On the one side, coming out with the Hindu Asmita, and the Mamata Banerjee tried to reduce its anger and did not come out with some harsh words against Narendra Modi. Voters did not angry that Mamata Narendra Modi is being abused. The more you will abuse, the more you will target Narendra Modi, the more old is the Mamata supporter base, and what Ramuji first genus by the voters of the West. Similarly, the campaign was quite aggressive. So Khela Hobe campaign and more campaign, and most importantly, Mamata Banerjee choosing a very weak state to contest elections have energized the voters and its party cadres in more than 50 constituencies. So Mamata Banerjee lost the election but secured the victory for its political party, because they have realized that let us focus the entire energy of the BJP in letting her lose the election in TMC in most of the assembly seats. So these are the people, and when we have many things to analyze, that did COVID was any factor in affecting the voting choices of the people to the advantage of the TMC? Let me tell you, my friends. See, the voting took place from sixth phase onwards. The COVID cases was quite high, and everybody was thinking that the TMC may get more and more votes because the COVID mismanagement was highlighted. All right, there is some element of truth in it, and I have analyzed that the around 8 phases of the election, TMC vote share did be won only 21 seats out of 112 seats in the phase 6 to 8. The success rate of the BJP in the last 3 phases was 18%, while the success rate of the BJP in the first 5 phases was 31% success rate. In fact, 56 seats won by BJP out of 180 seats from phase number 1 to 5. So there were some changes in the voting behavior in the last 3 phases. But if the same strike rate of 30% of BJP would have continued, if we take the COVID as an example, BJP would have increased only 14 seats. Still, BJP would have lost the election. So let me tell you, my friend, so what was being projected? We need to highlight that how that 8 phases elections, because 2 complaints are being made. If the 8 phases are there, it is sure and short gain for the BJP. If in the last 3 phases, COVID, due to COVID, BJP, TMC would get the benefit. In first phase, let me take the first phase as an example. In the first phase, there were 30 seats. In 2016 elections, TMC has won 21 seats and left Congress Alliance 8 seats, and BJP won. In 2016, TMC secured 27 seats, Left Alliance secured only 3 seats. If 2019 would have been yardstick, TMC should have get only 10 seats and BJP should have get 20 seats. But it did not happen. In 2021, TMC secured 18 seats and BJP 12 only. Similarly, in second phase, the election happened for 30 seats. In 2016, BJP performed very well in 21 seats, Left Alliance secured 8 seats and BJP won. In 2020, the TMC may have get 18 seats and improved seat and BJP securing 11 seats. In third phase, there were 31 seats. In 2016, TMC 29 and Left 2 secured 29 seats and BJP 12. But in 2021, TMC 27 and BJP 4 seats. So similarly, that in third phases and of every time the phase wise, if you will take the things into account, TMC has performed and consistently improved its strategy, its appeal, its campaign agenda in each phases. Taken into consideration, it did not take the opposition party quite easily, but is strong enough and then changes the strategy and they have won the seat. No doubt the people were not interested in 2%, 77%, 78% last three phases. So COVID was quite impactful. People were not turning out. Now the question is, why BJP lost the elections? So we have to look at those phenomena, because 2019 see at least 126 seats, but BJP got only 61%.
Hello?
Hello.
Yeah, go ahead, sir.
Audible?
Yeah, you are audible. You are audible.
So I'm really very sorry, because I'm of least help so far as internet connectivity is concerned. So we are, because lots of rumors are going on for 5G. So we have to for the still 5G giving to us. So here, because BJP somehow was able to keep its additional vote share intact, because it has won 39 seats out of the 84 reserved seats. So most of its victory came from the tribal and the scheduled caste reserved areas. 39 seats out of 77 is quite capable of present. Alipur in Darjeeling districts, it has won all the 10 seats. There are many other districts where BJP could not make a single seat there. There was no doubt it was a bipolar elections. Almost seats BJP was having a direct fight with TMC, but out of that, TMC won 199 seats. BJP was the runner-ups And so we can see that the BJP is still a very relevant force and it emerged as a dominant force. No doubt, a political party which has only 3 seats in 2016 in assembly elections, securing 77 seats and 38% votes is quite, but we cannot party based on 2016 because throughout the period, BJP elections. So why did BJP lost the election? Because the BJP become overconfident of its victory of 2019 elections. And it was the same things. And it become overconfident on Narendra Modi that Narendra Modi can deliver election even in panchayats, even in elections. He is the only leader. In fact, results in every assembly elections. This time, because the if I have to compare the election of 1987 elections when Rajiv Gandhi campaigned the elections in the entire West Bengal but failed to get any dignified seat. So because in 1984 seats, the Rajiv Gandhi was having an aura around Lok Sabha. 8% vote. So party thought that Rajiv Gandhi is very popular and therefore the campaign happened around Rajiv Gandhi. But Narendra Modi, campaigned for the entire West Bengal and thinking that this time they can beat, he can beat Mamata Banerjee. But it is realized that at the regional election, Mamata Banerjee was more popular, more powerful and more stronger than a so-called charismatic leader who's being treated as an incarnation by majority of the people in the country. Similarly, another fault of BJP was that they did not give tickets to the credible candidates because 146 candidates were poached candidates. They were from TMC and Congress and most of them were incumbency. In fact, they were the one experiencing anti-incumbency on the ground than the TMC leader. So, candidates were not given, that the BJP's candidate were not there of its own. They were not committed with the ideology of the party and they lacked with any agenda and therefore they lost the election. Similarly, there was a conflicting coordination between organic leadership of the party, co-opted leadership of the BJP, and then there was a central leadership. So there was a mismatch, miscoordination, and this duo that the Amit Shah and Narendra Modi, they become highly confident and the entire party mechanism become quite dependent that whatever they say, they may win. Similarly, there was an anti-incumbency against Narendra Modi and therefore he could not reach out to the people in West Bengal. So anti-incumbency because the Narendra Modi, the mismanagement of Narendra Modi government of COVID crisis, second was the farmers bill, third was the NRC and the CAA protest, because NRC CAA did help BJP in mobilizing Matua voters extent, but it counter-mobilized the Muslim voters to the advantage of the TMC, and therefore it's a great win for the TMC, because if you look at that, there were around 60 Muslim dominant seats which was won by the TMC, 55. So winning 55 seats, and out of that there were around 80 seats where the Muslims are 30%, and most of the seats was won by TMC. So the TMC was having a clear edge over the Muslim vote, having a clear edge over the Bengali voters. It was having a clear edge on the women voters. It was having a clear edge and it made a dent in the tribal areas, because if you look at the Jangal Mahal areas performance of the TMC, it has performed tremendous well, because Jhargram areas, which was earlier the base of the BJP lost its traditional bastion. And TMC did well. So TMC did take this election very seriously. They were fighting it with greater enthusiasm, with greater seriousness, with all the data at hand. They were not lambda. They have taken all the necessary steps which was needed to win the election. And the outcome is the Mamata Banerjee is the CM of Bengal third time. and she may win the next election. Now the focus is who is going to retain in the West Bengal. And I'm sure that in coming days, West Bengal is going to experience more exciting politics than what we have experienced now. Thank you. Thank you all for the opportunity and listening. And my apologies for the internet slowdown and fluctuations. Over to you, Ramus.
Thank you, Professor Afroz Alam, sir. Sumarga, 52 nimshala samayam paatu Professor Afroz Alam garu, 2021 Pachim Bengal, Sasana Sabha Enikalu, Palitalu. మమతా బెనర్జీ గెలుపు నరేంద్ర మోడీ ఓటమైనటువంటి అంశం మీద వారు సుదీర్ఘమైనటువంటి విశ్లేషణ చేయడం జరిగింది. ప్రధానంగా బెంగాల్లో ఉండేటువంటి బెంగాల్ రాష్ట్రంలో ప్రస్తుతం 9 కోట్ల మంది జనాభా ఉన్నారు, దాంట్లో 7 కోట్ల మంది ఓటర్లు ఉన్నారనే విషయాన్ని చెప్తూనే వారు మమతా బెనర్జీ గారు ప్రస్తుతం 45% ఓట్లను సాధించడం అనేటువంటిది జరిగింది. వారు 2011 నుండి నేటి వరకు ఓట్ల శాతాన్ని పెంచుకుంటూ బెంగాల్ ప్రజల లోపల వారి యొక్క పట్టును సాధించడం జరిగింది అనేటువంటి విషయాన్ని చాలా స్పష్టంగా ప్రొఫెసర్ ఆలం గారు చెప్పారు. వారికి మా తెలంగాణ జనవేదిక తరఫున ప్రత్యేకమైనటువంటి ధన్యవాదాలు సార్. వన్స్ అగైన్ ఐ థ్యాంక్ యూ వన్స్ అగైన్ ఆన్ బిహాఫ్ ఆఫ్ తెలంగాణ జనవేదిక సార్. థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్. ఇప్పుడు మిత్రులు ఎవరైనా మాట్లాడవారు ఉండేదంటే మాట్లాడవలసిందిగా వారిని ఆహ్వానిస్తున్నా. ఎవరైనా మిత్రులు సార్ వినపడుతుందా? రాము సార్ వినబడుతుందా?
యా వినబడుతుంది.
జేమ్స్ ప్లీజ్.
యా థ్యాంక్ యూ. ఇట్ వాజ్ వెరీ కాంప్రిహెన్సివ్ టాక్ ఆన్ ది ఎలక్షన్ ప్రొఫెసర్ ఆలం సార్. థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్ ఫర్ గివింగ్ అస్ ఆల్ ది ఇన్సైట్ ఇన్ టు వాట్ హ్యాపెండ్ ఇన్ ది ఎలక్షన్ ఇన్ బెంగాల్. Sir, I have one question. Is had the BJP conducted a normal election, that is like a two-phase election, you know, considering the fact that there was already a huge anti-incumbency situation in the state, and had they not campaigned a very highly polarizing election and just have done it in a two-phase election, what do you think would have been the outcome of this, sir? Have you, if also considering the fact that if COVID was not a factor in the election and it was like a normal situation and a two-phase election was conducted, what do you think could have happened? This is, can you please throw some light on it?
Because I told you in the beginning that the strike rate of BJP in the first to fifth phase elections was 30%. All right. So they have performed the first to fifth phase. And then COVID has got a manifold after sixth phase elections. So the strike rate of the BJP got reduced to 18%. The people thought of that the COVID is being badly mismanaged by BJP's government at the center. So if we think that COVID impact the election result to a minimal extent, that if the strike rate of the BJP of 30% would have been the same throughout the phases, then BJP would have added 14 seats.
Okay.
More. Means take for example 77 to 14 plus. Second question is, if we will look at the winning margin, you have to check the competitiveness of an election. We have to look at that, what is the winning margin? So there were around 22 seats which was won by the BJP with less than 5,000 margin. So had there been 1% vote shift against the BJP, the BJP would have been reduced to to 50 seats. By there were around 146 seats TMC won for more than 10,000 votes. So in fact, 156 seats was already in favor of the team, even if there is nothing else. And to win an election, 158 seats are needed.
Okay.
So to have a majority. So idea is COVID, BJP, TMC performed consistently well throughout the phases because it has it's lost two years and it has reduced its anti-incumbency with targeted campaign.
Wonderful. Okay.
Professor Sudhakar, Ramurthy is a cephalologist, he will talk.
You spoke very well and you gave all insights to us. I just like to add little things. See, the most important thing, I've been observing the elections for so many years, and see, the major change in the West Bengal election is the polling agent has to be from the local area only. This is the norm. They have changed this norm in the West Bengal, and the polling agent can be from any constituency to suit the BJP, which never happened in the country. This is the first time which has happened in West Bengal. The election commission has amended because they doesn't have the polling agents throughout the state. To manage that, they wanted eight-phase election, and they made the election commission to include this norm. This is the first observation. Second, along with Mamata Banerjee, her nephew also played very big role in the election. He has campaigned, Abhishek Mukherjee campaigned extensively in West Bengal, and he has received crowds overwhelmingly, and there is good response from the youth. And thirdly, and if you look into it, there were seats from the margin between 1,000 to 500 are around 50 constituencies. If those we take into calculation, if that also come to this thing, the BJP would have been left around with the 26 seats only. And the other factor, the counter the Hindu factor, Mamata also played in all our meetings. One is the Jai Bangla slogan. And secondly, she was telling that I'm a Brahmin, and she used to recite the slogan, she used to recite these things. Kali mantra and all to give that this thing. I'm a Hindu Brahmin, and she used to say one more thing. Though I'm a Brahmin, for last 25 years, my cook is from the scheduled caste. So she used to be very clear about the concept of the Brahmin and scheduled caste and Hinduism. She used to counter that way in all her speeches. These are my few observations. Thank you,
Madam Vibha Varalakshmi.
Now, this is not Vibha Varalakshmi, Ramu. This is Professor Sanjeev Reddy, actually.
Oh, sorry.
Afroz, actually, my daughter was using the phone, so she changed that name. Afroz, thank you so much. But very unfortunately, only after James asked you the first question, my audio became very clear. Unfortunately, I missed your total lecture, Afroz. It was not at all clear. I don't know. Very, very unfortunate. This is the first time it has happened.
Yes, sir. Correct.
It happened like this, because we so many, Ramu has conducted so many, but it never happened. Sorry, Afroz, but just bits and pieces I could hear. Fifologist, he was pointing out to your lecture. I'm sure it was indeed very insightful lecture. So thank you very much for obliging us. This is the only reason why I came here, to thank you profusely for sharing your time. And it was nice to know that.
I'm really sorry.
It was also, please, one second. It was also nice to know that you were working with Yogendra also. That was amazing. I knew that you were in CSDS, but I missed the connection between you and Yogendra. So that's very nice to have a great personality like you are delivering for us at Telangana Janavedika. And we look forward to continue our association in the future also, Afroz. Please do oblige us whenever we call you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Sanjeev sir, because audio to hear because the internet connectivity is very down in my area, and this is also happening for the first time in my talk. And but that, my talks sad. And my are available on your on my Democratic Conversation channel, where I am consistently done videos for starting from the election till the outcome analysis. So it's yeah. available on my channel if anybody is interested to go through that.
Sure. Thank you, Afroz. Yes. Thank you. Please make sure that you are part of the family now, that you'll have to oblige us whenever we do request.
Exactly.
It's not an academic fraternity. Anything for academic fraternity.
Correct. Thank you so much, brother. Thank you.
Praveen Sagar
is here.
Good evening to everyone. Good evening to Ramana for organizing wonderful session on this Bengal elections. And thanks to the professor who has given a wonderful speech and explanation about 2021 West Bengal elections. So I have a couple of questions to the professor. Like, so in West Bengal, there is around 27% of Muslims and there and about 70% of Hindus. I mean, the votes are also in the same ratio. So does Bangladesh Muslims, Rohingya Muslims or whatever it is, does that make any impact in these elections? This is my first question. The second question is like, Prashant Kishore has played a major role in winning of these elections to Trinamool, Mamata Banerjee's party. So does he play a key role in these elections as well as where BJP got 1/4 of the seats, like around 70 odd, and 3/4 to the Trinamool Congress party. So is BJP happy with the seats that they got compared to the previous elections? They were no more in the contest. Now they are around 1/4. So, I mean, how does we have to see? Like, is BJP really lost the elections or they are in... their graph is moving upward. So these are my questions to you, sir. Thank you.
Praveen, very interesting questions. The first is, I'll take a Muslims part questions. Because Muslim voters, like many similar ways, because we have to look at the question that they are not monolith voters. They are as divided as any other voters, and they were each as Bengali and non-Bengali Muslims. Undoubtedly, because there are local issues, local concerns, and lots of Muslim political trying there to win over them and divide them. They have voted consistently for left, they have voted for Congress, they have voted for TMC, their vote been divided. This time, the way there is a consolidation of certain Muslim in favor of BJP, of Mamata Banerjee, it goes on, and they have say no to Congress and left strategically and tactically to the advantage of TMC. It's a very Mamata Banerjee who has made use of NRC, CAA and all other agenda, and somehow with tacit understanding of Congress, their votes did not get divided. So it's not about Rohingya and others. They have a very minimal presence in those states. They may are not move. So they can give you certain things, but their religious shrine who was contesting the election. So they said no to the Muslim specific parties and said yes to Bengali force political party Mamata Banerjee. Because I have to look at that. There are 126 Muslims, Hindu populations are above 8% of the size, where TMC won 126 seats and BJP secured 19 seats. So how can we say that where Muslims are not in sizable population is
26 seats. Around 100 and PMC winning 126 seats. So we cannot say that there was a conflict. There was a polarization. Similarly, the second question was Prashant Kishore. No doubt, he is highly professional man, but professional man will not be of any party which he is not responding to the in Uttar Pradesh. Prashant Kishore was a big failure because Congress and the Samajwadi Party did not respond to his party, therefore it was a greater cause. In West Bengal, Mamata Banerjee might change his campaign in terms of his speech and rhetoric, huge credit, but cannot be solely and wholly. So Mamata Banerjee's urge to win the elections, his nephew, what other person has recently highlighted. So that can be said that this solely Prashant Kishore, but no doubt.
సార్ క్లోజ్ చేయండి సార్, ఆడియో లేదు వీడియో లేదు, చాలా ప్రాబ్లం ఉంది. ఫస్ట్ టైం మనకి
ఓకే మనోజ్
యా గుడ్ ఈవినింగ్ ఎవ్రీవన్, గుడ్ ఈవినింగ్ టు ద రెస్పెక్టెడ్ తెలంగాణ జనవేదిక మెంబర్స్. ముందుగా గురుగారు పురుషోత్తమరావు గారికి నమస్కారాలు తెలుపుకుంటూ, వెరీ డీటెయిల్డ్ explanation by Alam ji. Thank you so much, sir, for giving your presence today. And going to the West Bengal politics, BJP leadership kept all the powers to get to gain in the West Bengal. And if they could have won the West Bengal election, their main agenda was to go to Jimli elections, what I personally believe. But the consequences were different there. Mamata could have won and managed landslide victory in West Bengal. And what BJP's leadership is planning to snub the regional parties in all the states, including Telangana, and they also wanted, they also tried in Tamil Nadu also, but they couldn't. As Ramamurthy Garu just now said, he said some important points that even that that number given to BJP in West Bengal elections also is very big, and we should wait and see what will happen in the future in coming elections and all that. And thank you, Ramanna, for giving me opportunity. Thank you so much.
సార్ ఇంకెవరైనా మిత్రులు మాట్లాడేవారు ఉంటే దయచేసి మాట్లాడండి ప్లీజ్.
ఉమామహేశ్వర రెడ్డి,
ఉమామహేశ్వర రెడ్డి గారు
ఉమామహేశ్వర రెడ్డి అన్మ్యూట్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్, అన్మ్యూట్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ ప్లీజ్.
హలో 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 నమస్తే అన్న, టీజేవి అధ్యక్షుల గారికి, సభాధ్యక్షులు శ్రీనివాస్ అన్న, నమస్తే. ప్రొఫెసర్ గారు చాలా మంచి చెప్పారు. ఇప్పుడు వెస్ట్ బెంగాల్లో ఇంత ల్యాండ్ స్లైడ్ విక్టరీ రావడానికి కారణము కొద్దిమంది చెప్తున్నారన్న, ఎలక్షన్స్ అయిపోయాక కాంగ్రెస్ ఇంకా కమ్యూనిస్ట్ పార్టీల సపోర్ట్ వల్లనే ఆమె గెలవగలిగింది అని. అంటే వీళ్ళు వీళ్ళు హిడెన్ ఎజెండాగా ఒకటిగా అయ్యి గెలిపించారు అని. మరి అది నేను ప్రొఫెసర్ గారిని అర్థం అనుకుంటు కానీ వారికి మనకి ఇప్పుడు వస్తలేదు కాబట్టి మళ్ళీ వచ్చే వారంలో రామన్న గారితో తెలుసుకుంటారు. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
ఇంకెవరైనా మిత్రులు ఉంటే మాట్లాడగలరు ప్లీజ్.
సుధాకర్ సార్. సుధాకర్ సార్.
సార్ ప్రొఫెసర్ సుధాకర్ గారు. ప్రొఫెసర్ సుధాకర్ సార్.
సుధాకర్ సార్ కూడా ఇంటర్నెట్ ఛానల్ వీక్ ఉన్నదంట.
సో అందరి అదే ప్రాబ్లం సార్, మెయిన్ స్పీకర్ ప్రాబ్లం ఉంది, వేరే వాళ్ళు కూడా చాలా కష్టమే సార్.
Pritisha, Advocate Pritisha, would you like to ask any question?
Yeah, sure, sir, if you allow me.
Yeah, yeah, please speak, please speak.
First of all, thank you for inviting me. Sir, I have two questions, if you allow me to ask. First question is, why Mamata Banerjee won? Is it because she was very fast in countering the narrative set by the BJP, or whether she has a very good ground in Bengal that she has made in the last 5 years? And my second question is, why Congress lost? Is it because Congress has maintained its secular identity in Bengal, or Congress failed to set any narrative in Bengal? Thank you, sir. Is my question clear, sir?
Yeah.
Am I audible?
You are audible. Please,
I told exhaustively why and how TMC won this election undoubtedly to win 2 years. She has worked.
It's completely unable to hear.
Hello. I don't know. This is for the first time happening with my internet, that my internet getting disconnected.
We can hear you. We can hear you now, Professor.
Hear you.
Yeah, Mamata Banerjee was quick to realize its shortcomings and try to overcome it in less than 2 years period. It realized that there is anti-incumbency among women voters, among tribal and Dalits, among the agriculture laborers and peasants, and it has some problems. Some leaders of TMC did not deliver well on the ground. So those things she had a planning, because she got through all the data using a professional campaign agency, and therefore she planned. Most of its schemes during this period was quite populist, like Dware Sarkar, Swasth Sakti, Rupa Sri Sarkar, and therefore she has that sort of will to win the election. And she won, and it is a huge win. What was the another question?
It's about Congress, sir.
Yeah, Congress, yeah. See, Congress, you know, that lost the whole gain in West Bengal after in 77 elections, because 1972 election was the election performed humongously well, securing 216 seats and 49% votes. So it's far bigger a win than TMC now. But over the period of time, Congress did not show its willingness to win the state confined to the Lok Sabha election. So there was certain sort of understanding between left and Congress, and fine, in Lok Sabha you support me and in assembly elections we will not be exchanging. So their local did not get the energy. Similarly, they had the strong base in Muslim dominant areas like Murshidabad and the rural areas and Malda areas, Uttar Dinajpur areas. So certain Muslim those seats they lost because they were winning those seats for a longer period of time, but their MLAs did not do well. This time, the voters substantially and particularly Muslims shifted toward TMC and they did not secure surprisingly in Murshidabad area. There is a less cadre support, there is a less political will to win. There is a task standing with the parliamentary election and assembly election of the Congress by TMC or later by the BJP. So there was no significant way we are lacking narratives. It a reason whether we it is a representative at least they were confined to certain assembly constituencies. So they become an assembly constituency political party. Two assembly constituency parties. Undoubtedly, they secured well 44 seats in 2016, but that victory did not continue because another big forces joined the West Bengal that is taken all the or most of the votes from the Congress own poll.
Okay, thank you, sir.
James, you wanted to ask something?
No, sir, I'm fine. This came right.
Thank you, Pruthi.
James was having a question whether it is a greater win for BJP or something else. And of course, BJP was always knowing that it is fighting for a position. They had to strategize their cadres that they can win 200. If they will not say that they can win 200, they would have reduced to 20 seats only. That's a win, but 2019 is a yardstick when they had secured and almost 126 seats got reduced to 7. So it's a loss from 2019 and gain from 2016.
But I guess it has created a space for it. For itself now in the state.
They knew because you know huge chunk they have there is a deep polarization. You cannot deny that. And there was a deep anti-incumbency against Mamata Banerjee. It's all about micromanagement of Mamata Banerjee. Somehow Mamata dealt with anti-incumbency. Otherwise, if Mamata would have been quite easygoing and not taking the 2019 results seriously, BJP would have been in power in 2021. BJP fights every election seriously, even in panchayat elections. They rope in Prime Minister to win the Pradhani seats, Zilla Parishad membership seats, and while other people become quite lazy. So you cannot afford laziness and power at the same time. You cannot win election on Twitter alone. Digital media activism should be reflected on ground. Anybody else?
So is that a direction to Congress?
Congress has always a direction, but it should take it seriously.
Well said.
No, it has always.
It is still to come out of its feudal image. You know that most of its party members enjoyed power for long. For them, winning and losing is immaterial. But for the cadres on the ground, who is having life and death at stake, they are not getting support from the top leadership or the intermediate leadership. what they will do. So they need power. They need hunger to win the elections.
Exactly.
If you're not having that hunger to win the elections, nothing can be done. So it has to be, it has to be more like a phoenix. You know that.
Very true.
Need to discipline is correct. It's cadres. There must be discipline. Everybody is powerful in Congress. Any questions?
Ahmed, do you have anything to ask? Ahmed. Okay.
So one.
Can you please?
Yeah. James.
Yeah. So, so Professor Alam, so it does look like the famous Bhadralok of Bengal have stayed put with Mamata Banerjee this time around. We're losing. We are not able to hear you.
So, Bhadralok is the privileged section of the society. They are always having a no. Who is losing?
Okay.
You are not audible, sir. You are not audible. Please unmute yourself, sir, again.
Okay. First time in the last of many years, I'm experiencing this much of internet slowdown. See that Bhadralok is a category, and it is a privileged category. They will remain in power whosoever may come to power. So it is a metro. Undoubtedly, they are the power machine and they will hold power. They are the people who are least in number who do vote in the election. It is rural people.
Poor people.
Hello.
Sir, please conclude, gents.
Alam sir, bab ke internet ko BJP wale atkare dikh raha mere ko to.
Who's over?
Yeah.
Because we are analysts, we don't go with party ideologies. Finally, you can conclude because it's Bhadralok and Chhotalok is not, but BJP was a greater success in mobilizing lower OBCs and Dalits and tribals. No doubt. Yes, so I should take leave.
Anyway, thank you so much, sir. It's very unfortunate. It was very unfortunate that we could not get you properly on this line. We'll have a better luck next time. Thank you so much for joining us. Your talk was extremely, extremely useful.
Yes.
And it threw light on the future of the Indian politics, how to manage elections, micromanagement and all those things were very useful. We will have to have it one-to-one discussion on this along with Professor Sanjeev Reddy. Thank you very much. And I'll hand over to Professor Akhtota Srinivasulu to close the meeting. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Telangana Janavedika Zoom online meeting, which is the keelaka upanyasam ichinatvanti Professor Afroz Alam sir ki Telangana Janavedika tarapuna pratyekamainatvanti dhanyavaadalu sir. Ade vidhanga ee naati karyakramalu padukunnatvanti Professor Sanjeev Reddy గారికి, Professor Sudhakar గారికి, Ramurthy గారికి, అదేవిధంగా ప్రవీణ్ సాగర్ గారికి, మనోజ్ రెడ్డి గారికి, ఉమామేశ్వర రెడ్డి గారికి, ప్రీతి షా గారికి, ఇందులో పాల్గొన్నటువంటి ప్రతి ఒక్కరికి పేరు పేరున ధన్యవాదాలు తెలియజేసుకుంటూ ఈనాటి కార్యక్రమం ఇంతటితో ముగుస్తుందని తెలియజెప్పుకుంటూ దయచేసి మిత్రులందరినీ క్షమించగలరని మరొకసారి కోరుకుంటున్నాను. ఎందుకంటే ఇవాళ మేము 380 మీటింగులు చేసినప్పటికీ ఇవాళ ఉన్న ప్రాబ్లము ఈ 380 మీటింగ్ లో ఎప్పుడు కూడా నేను ఈ అధ్యక్ష స్థానంలో కూర్చొని ఎప్పుడు వినలేకపోయాను. అందరూ మిత్రులు అందరూ క్షమించగలరని మరొకసారి మేము అందరిని కోరుకుంటూ ఈనాటి ఈ కార్యక్రమం ఇంతటితో ముగిస్తున్నాం. థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్. థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్.
థ్యాంక్ యూ ప్రొఫెసర్ ఆలం.
ఆలం సాబ్ ఈద్ ముబారక్.
Thank you all of you.
Thank you all. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Other programs when my internet is.
It's okay. It happens. But you have a safe and wonderful Eid, sir. Eid Mubarak to you in advance. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Eid Mubarak, sir.
Eid Mubarak, sir. Professor Alam. Thank Eid you so Mubarak. Much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you all. Good night.
Yeah, good night.
Good night.
Sir, I'm going to write 4 lines.